Lance, how you doing today?
Never better. Thanks for having us.
Yeah. So I'm sitting here with Hitched in their corporate headquarters in here in Houston, Texas. Big shout out to y'all. Y'all are a big supporter of what we're doing. We're a big supporter of what you're doing. But I think there's some people out there that aren't quite sure what Hitched does. What does Hitched do?
Sure. I mean, essentially what we are is an industrial marketplace and management tool for anything that is equipment or, you know, chemicals, goods and services. We have worked really hard to bring a technical solution to an industry that previously wasn't super tech savvy, and we're really trying to bring a huge value add to all of our operators, service companies, equipment providers by bringing together kind of a global marketplace and management tools so that they can not only rent, buy, and sell stuff, but they can see on a daily basis what their cost is, what their spend is, what their earnings are, and, you know, basically have a better tool to see on a day-to-day basis where they're at.
So how did this start? Did y'all see a problem in the market and said, you know what, we're going to fix it?
That's one of our, like, favorite topics, right? Because my co-founder, Adam Gillis, and I, we ate, breathed, slept oil and gas problems. You know, we had started chemical companies in oil and gas. We had done service companies. Adam ran a really big water transfer company, and being in the day-to-day problems, we were dealing with the types of situations that we were trying to solve every day. And because of that, we said, all right, there's got to be a better way. And being young kind of tech guys, you know, we're constantly using all of the different tech apps. You know, we said, you know, just like everybody else, there's got to be an app for that, right? And there wasn't for what we were doing. And so as entrepreneurial guys, we said, we can go and figure out how to solve that problem. And so we just kind of jumped out and took the industry knowledge and the contacts that we had, and we just started one by one going through the problems and trying to fix them.
So I've been in this industry for a long time, and it was not that long ago. In fact, it's probably still going on. You go out to Midland or go out to North Dakota or anywhere, and you need a piece of equipment. There's a paper directory in the back of your truck.
That's right. Right.
And you pull that paper directory out, and you leaf through, and you're like, who has a forklift? And so that is like one of the things that I think is so cool about what you're doing is you eliminate all of that.
That's right. Yeah, I mean, essentially, so at the previous service company we were at, we literally had one or two guys who their whole job was basically to go through their Rolodex and try and find, you know, people with different pieces of equipment. And you get on the phone with somebody you knew and said, I got you covered, man. I know you need three of them. I got two. And then, you know, he's like, oh, I'll call you back. You know what? Actually, one of those got rented out. We don't. You know, and so then he goes back to the, you know, and his whole job was trying to manage this, you know, supply chain issue, which is a nightmare. There's so much disintermediation within this industry. We knew that would be a good get for us to go and try and fix.
Yeah, it's nobody will admit it, but supply chain's an issue in this industry. The entire industry, upstream, midstream, downstream, even the service companies have supply chain issues. And being able to fix that is an incredible way to drive efficiencies, right? Which right now, in this low crude price environment, driving efficiencies is the name of the game.
That's right. I mean, part of what was really important to us, because we've been in the industry for such a long time, we have friends that are a part of the midstream, the upstream, and the downstream, and oil and gas being so cyclical, we see the pressure on all of their businesses, right? And you know the stories, and you know the people, and so we said, look, if we can bring some sort of a consistency to the marketplace by giving more visibility and accountability to our friends within their businesses and ourselves, like, that's the best way to stabilize a market. That's the best way to help them. So when, you know, the market does go down, there's not a bunch of layoffs because we've kept them efficient the entire time, rather than, you know, what we've seen is, you know, market dips and everybody's scrambling for efficiencies and the market goes good and you know, life is good, right? But so the goal for us was, okay, how do we keep everybody consistently efficient with their cost and visibility and accountability with where they're at? And if we can do that, then, you know, the downs aren't as bad, and, you know, and maybe the uptimes don't necessarily seem as plentiful, but they actually are more plentiful because they've kept a good cadence throughout their company.
All right, so I want to talk about, like, rubber hit the road executable stuff, and I want you to tell the story from two different angles.
Okay. Okay.
Let's do angle number one. All right, let's say I'm a service company out in West Texas somewhere, and I need an off-road forklift. How would they work with you?
Sure. So if you're a service company and, you know, hey, the majority of what drives them to us are a couple of different things. One is utilization, right? They've got equipment in the yard. bank's always going to get their check, right? No matter what. Like, whether it's out on rent or not on rent, bank's always going to get their check. And so
Lance, I want to tell the story two different ways, right? So, number one, let's talk about from an operator point of view. How would an operator engage with you? Let's say they need an off-road forklift.
Right. Yeah, so operators, I mean, typically what they do is, you know, they're coming to us to find good vendors, to work with their vendors, to, you know, you got to think about, like, we look at everything through the lens of a job site or a rig or whatever, because really what their main challenge is they're looking at it saying, I've got, you know, anywhere from 5 to 15 different vendors out there who have different pieces of equipment, who have different service times, who have different payment schedules. And so for me as an operator, it's a big kind of a management nightmare, right? And not only that, it's the coordination of equipment traveling and being there and being on site and being fueled. And so when you have all of these aspects coming to Hitched, we act as kind of the conduit that manages all that for the operator. And so they come to us, they get on the platform. It's a simple process. We've got a sales engineering team that we link them up with. And the sales engineering process takes about 15 minutes. They're all onboarded. We kind of get them set up with as a vendor or as a, you know, as a operator, as a end user, as we call it, on our system. And then, you know, essentially we gain some information with our customer success team on who their preferred vendors are, what types of activities we do. Like, we really try and get to know our end user customers' preferences and really what their goals are, because then what kind of happens is I think operators get pigeonholed with people they know as far as providers, yep. Right? Because and service companies, because I know this guy, I'm comfortable with this guy, and we want them to still be able to work with those people, but we want to give them a little bit broader perspective in the instance that, hey, maybe they're drilling in a completely different spot now, or maybe they're completing over here, or maybe they're spread too thin, and so they come to Hitch to, you know, get a wider range of really great providers and service companies, and they also come to us to kind of help manage that, you know, that user case of, you know, we've got all this equipment, we've got all these services, and, you know, it's really hard to keep track of everybody on site, and so we do that.
One of the things I love about what y'all do is, and I've seen people, you may not admit this to your accounting team, but I've seen multiple times where a piece of equipment's being rented and it's not being used,
right,
because nobody knows it's there.
Sure.
But it's that day rate's triggered all the time.
That's right.
And
that's right.
Y'all, not only do y'all eliminate that, y'all then give reports back so that if I need that piece of equipment for 3 hours here and 7 hours here,
right,
you can tell the operator it was here for 3 hours and
that's
it was
right
here for 6 hours, even though they charge you for seven.
That's right.
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 And so you just make it so efficient to manage that infrastructure of stuff that you need in the oil field.
That's right. And, you know, again, it's for an operator's perspective, it's about clarity and understanding what my true costs are, right? Because ultimately they create their budgets and they want it to go as long as they can. And it's in the little pieces, it's in the hour here and the couple minutes here and the lost efficiency there that we feel like the game is won or lost. So,
yeah. And can you talk a little bit from an operator's point of view, from a financial reporting point of view? Because I think that's another big strength
sure
you all have.
Yeah, I mean, essentially what we do is, I mean, two big financial things that I think we've helped with is, one, like I said, managing that single vendor payment system where, you know, instead of, you know, asking, you know, this guy, Joe and Tom and Larry for their paper invoices and all that sort of stuff, you know, it's all managed and paid through the Hitch portal, which is super great because per job site, they can kind of go out and they can even build their job site, right? They can get on the platform, they can build the job site, they can add their equipment and services, they can see the totality of what that job is going to cost. And because of that, then they can kind of start going out and looking at their drilling and completion schedule, and they can start looking at real costs and having a better understanding of, okay, here's where our spend is more likely going to be, rather than saying, hey, we're going to make guesstimates and we're going to do our, you know, they do a good job, but I think ultimately it's having this, like I said, the whole clear vision laid out for them and the little pieces where we can kind of help bring them cost savings as far as, hey, you know what, this is the guy you're using and they're great, but, you know, here's another option as you expand that, you know, maybe they're a little bit cheaper or maybe their service is a little bit better because, really, as an operator, their main thing is I don't want to shut down.
Right.
And so I need the very best service possible. That means providers who can, you know, be there on time and bring good equipment and they're servicing the equipment on a regular basis so that it stays up and running. And we understand that. And because we understand that, and we understand the visualization of what they're spending on a day-to-day basis matters. And I think from a financial tool perspective, having those two things, the single vendor payment system and the visual data realization of what's happening, is just a huge benefit.
Yeah, the other thing I love about what y'all do from an operator point of view is everybody has their preferred vendors.
Sure.
But sometimes that preferred vendor, for whatever reason, can't deliver.
Right.
With the Hitched app, I got 30 backups.
That's right.
There's no interruption.
Right. Yeah.
All right, so let's tell a story from the other side. Let's tell it from the service companies who have equipment that they want to make sure their utilization rate is as close to 100%. So how do y'all work with them?
Right. So essentially, the way in which we have worked with a lot of our providers and really great service companies is, you drive down Midland or you drive down really anywhere, there's, guys with, yards of equipment that, want their stuff to be out. They want their stuff to be working and on the clock. And, there's an interesting dynamic within oil and gas. And, whether you're an operator or a provider or a service company, you're relying on certain factors of the industry to kind of connect the dots. Now, a lot of times that's missed. A lot of times you may just not know an RFP has gone out. A lot of times you just may have not been in the in or you didn't have the right contact. And not that it's a function of, it's not malicious by any means, but it's a function of just being, knowing what's going on. And so by bringing a marketplace that, has a good relationship with operators and midstream companies and service companies, because what's so unique about our providers and our service companies is we have people on the platform who both rent and get rented from, or rent and get services done. And so it's really interesting that, we kind of bring this full end system for a provider or service company, because we allow them, not only are they going and fulfilling the needs of an operator's job site and approaching it that way, but they act sometimes as their own little job site, right? Where they're saying, I need things to go and do my service because I may have the MSA for the operator and, these three great companies don't, but they can come work under my MSA. And so we act as a great tool for them as well to say, great, we can pull together this grouping of, everybody wants to bundle right now. So we help them put together a good package that's at a really competitive rate for the operator. And they can take that complete package back to the operator. And now they've got a full complete system. But their journey with us starts with, they're called our sales engineers, but we also have procurement supply chain people who work with that side. And so they're constantly going out and they're vetting service companies and providers based off of, safety history, based off of, service history within the industry. And, we talk to a lot of references with all these companies we bring on, because it's not only their credibility, but it's our credibility, right? And so we want to bring the very best providers and service companies to our operators. And so what we've done and their journey, they get together with our, we call them PSCs, our procurement supply chain people, and they're onboarded in, we do an onboarding in about 30 minutes, because with those guys, we want to make sure that we understand their pricing of all their equipment. We help them onboard all their equipment or chemicals or anything they want to sell, or understand their service. And, what's tricky about this side of the marketplace, rather than like a traditional e-commerce, is as we're dealing with chemicals and sand and mud and water, the way in which it's bought or paid for is, it gets tricky, right? Whether it's in ISOs or it's in gallons or it's in totes, and the way in which it's ordered is different than how it's billed, right? And, also too, renting a piece of equipment is much more tricky in oil and gas than, say buying, a forklift, right? Because when I rent, I have terms, I have billing cycles, I have fueling and maintenance schedules. And so within this discovery process of onboarding, we help them, we help understand, you know, kind of what their best practices are for their equipment or services or deliverables. And we build that process out with our team to make sure that the operator gets the best experience. So we onboard them and get them onto the platform, and then they're in the ecosystem.
So if I'm a service company and I've predominantly worked in Midland or worked in the Permian, and all of a sudden I get a gig with one of my operators in the Haynesville, you tell me I can go up there with the Hitch app and I can find all the parts and pieces I need, even though I don't know anybody in Haynesville.
Right.
That is really cool.
Right. I mean, and that's one of the key selling points, right? Is ultimately they should be able to go anywhere in any county, in any state, and our ultimate goal is anywhere in the world, and go be able to do a job well and you know, do it very profitably. So
perfect segue, because that was my next question is, right now you're operating in the U.S. or North America?
So right now we're in, you know, in the U.S.,
okay.
But I mean, prolifically in North America, and, you know, Permian Basin, Bakken, Marcellus. We've really focused a lot of our energy and efforts there, just because that's where we got our start,
right?
And that's where a lot of our good friends and contacts are. So,
what's the future for Hitch?
You know, the future is going to be interesting. I think as we push to other basins, you know, there are equal but different challenges, right? In the Permian Basin, it was more of a logistics and supply chain. As we push into the Bakken, the Marcellus, there are a few other different touch points that are similar, but you know, I think we'll see some new challenges as we push out. But ultimately, it's kind of going into those markets, understanding their problems, and giving kind of a turnkey solution for operators to go into different basins to expand their reach and really to be able to go in and give them that ability to go be profitable anywhere in the world at all. And I think from there we'll kind of see in oil and gas, but oil and gas has kind of been our baby. I mean, we're looking at some other industrial sectors because we see similar problems, right? It's an efficiency deal. It's how do we do an industrial project at a very efficient cost? And so we're getting really good at understanding those problems. And then we're taking the knowledge and data that we get from doing it. We're passing, you know, the benefit on to our operators, our contractors, and you know, vice versa, back to our providers and our service users. So.
Yeah, I love how y'all have taken technology and made it something that is valuable. The technology almost disappears, right?
That's
you
right.
Don't see what's going on behind it. It's just, I need this, I got it, whatever. The other thing I love about that is y'all have very much a human touch in this industry. This industry has always been an industry of people doing business with people.
Sure.
And y'all are the same. I mean, y'all are great.
It has to be that way, right? I mean, when we looked at initially, you know, we were worried, like, that bringing a tech solution to an industry that's super personable and face-to-face handshake deals, it was something that we thought long and hard about. And the experience that we wanted people to have was a similar experience, but just the added benefit of having a tech platform behind it.
Yeah. So finally, the last question is, you're working with us, Oil and Gas Global Network. Why'd y'all choose to work with us?
I mean, that's a great question. And I think really it's rooted in thought leadership. When we looked at our market, the market that we have grown, we've sweat for, we've cried about, we've worked so hard to build our industry, we wanted to be a part of shaping, you know, the right mentality, the right thought leadership. We wanted to be a part of helping bring better solutions to this industry. And we saw you guys as that partner who was super communicative, who had who knew their stuff from an industry perspective, who had integrity, who had, the right understanding and perspective of how not only am I going to benefit from this, but what are the best solutions to bring to the industry to make it grow so that we can continue to all do this. So there is something to continue to talk about. And we saw you guys as the ones who are making people lean in to the conversation of what the oil and gas industry is. And, you know, being younger guys, you know, we're looking at our peers and we're saying, man, there's all this talent going other places. Let's get the conversation going and get them coming back in. And you were the ones to do that. And it inspired us. It inspired us to want to be a part of shaping the thought leadership in this industrial sector. And you know, we're just super impressed with all you guys have done and are just happy to support and maybe add our little perspective and some knowledge that we have on the industry, and hopefully, you know, people listening to this, you know, join the conversation, and we've seen that, and we've really wanted to be a part of something great that you guys have built. So
yeah, and we're all part of something great. This is the best industry on the planet.
True.
Lance, man, this has been awesome. Thank you so much for coming on.
Yeah, thank you as well. Appreciate it.